the Lord will exalt him. He's won the victory.
When you don't have the kind of lives someone is living at the moment, just admire the person and pray that one day you will be like the person or even be better than the person. Quit being bitter. Quit being jealous. Quit being envious, you know, thereby turning to a witch. Quit being a witch. Okay? Quit being a witch.
Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Debbie in the building. Guys, you have already known what we are going to talk about today. So I'll start by asking, who is a witch? A witch is anybody that does not like to see people succeed, or you don't like to see people happy, you don't like to see people progressing. You are a witch. Yes. Anyone that always wants to see the downfall of people, all you want to see is people's downfall, all you want to see is people shedding tears, you try to do everything possible to bring people down, all you do is try to make up stories, you know, make up bad stories, negative stories, try to paint people black, you know, just try to do anything that will bring pain or hurt people. You are a witch. You are a witch. So anything that will bring about bitterness, envy, jealousy is act of witchcraft. Yes, it is act of witchcraft, of wickedness. Yeah, witchcraft is not only when you do sorcery or when you have magic powers. No. Witchcraft can also be when you don't like seeing good things. Yes, that is also witchcraft. Yes. Now I want to talk about jealousy, because jealousy has a huge role to play when it comes to being a witch. Because the only thing I see that will make someone not to see his or her fellow human being and progressing and get offensive about it or get angry about it, or something that will make someone to just wake up one day and make up lies and, you know, just trying to bring down his or her fellow human being, is jealousy. There's nothing that can cause that apart from jealousy. So I'll be talking about jealousy. There are two types of jealousy, the good one and the bad one. What am I saying? What do I mean by a good one and bad one? Can anything good come from jealousy? Yes. The good jealousy is the one that comes with admiration. I don't even know if there's any word like admiration. What I mean by that is someone that, as in, the one that comes with you admiring someone, you know, in the sense that you can see something now that is good in someone. Let me just say, this person has a nice eyes, you know, nice set of eyes, and you'll be like, I like this, so I am jealous, so I wish I have this, your eyes. That one is good jealousy, you know. So the second one, the bad one, is the one that comes with hatred. The one that will see those good set of eyes of yours and they'll be like, she is not her natural eyes, so she fixed contact lens, so she went for surgery and blah 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 blah. Now what? So that is the two types of jealousy I'm talking about, the good one and the bad one. Now, let me tell you the rule, the rules these two different types of jealousy plays. The good jealousy would make you to get close to that person. You know, when you see someone that's, when you admire someone, you see someone that is doing well, you know, and you wish you are the person, you wish to do well, you want to also be like that person, you get. It makes you to draw closer to the person, try to be friends with the person, try to learn from that person. That is good jealousy. But this bad jealousy, the only thing it will make you to do, the one that comes with hatred, you automatically hate the person. Maybe you don't even know this person from Adam. You're not even close to the person. You've not even had anything to do with them, as in had any relationship with the person to know the character or the person's life. And, but once, because of out of that jealousy, you've seen that thing that is good in the person, you start spreading false news. You start saying all manner of things about the person. Okay, if it's someone that made money, you'll be like, ah, who knows what she's doing? Maybe she's a person. Maybe she did this. Maybe she did just because of jealousy. You've looked at yourself. You cannot be able to do that thing. Or you look at yourself. The person is doing better than you. And you see yourself that you cannot be able to, you know, get that thing that person has, or maybe you are not lucky as that person, you know, you start spreading false news, you start, you know, doing all manner of things just to put the person down, just to make the person look bad, just to make people not to come have any reason to come close to the person and all that. My dear, if you are doing that, you are a witch. You are a witch. In this 2020, it's better you step up. Try the good jealousy part. Yes, it's not good to be jealous, but somehow it's also good to be jealous because somehow it makes you to do better. That is why I say good jealousy. Good jealousy makes you to do better. When you are admiring someone, let me just use the word because when I say when you're jealous of someone, it sounds somehow, yeah, but when you are admiring someone, it helps you do better because it helps you to improve yourself, you know, you want to do like be like that person, so it helps you to do better, push yourself more harder just to be like that person. That's the good aspect of jealousy, you get. But the negative part, the bad part, if you are that person that once you see someone that is looking good, you want to, you have a negative thing to link to that person's appearance, as in you just have a negative thing to say about that person, to just to bring the person down just because the person is looking good. Like they, you are a witch. If you are that person that once you see someone that is progressing, you will just have something, a story to tell or something to say about that person just to paint a picture that, ah, this person progress is not real and all that. You are a witch. Yes, you are a witch. So in this 2020, try to deal with everything that associates you with negative or bad jealousy. If you don't like someone, it's okay for you not to like someone. You mustn't like everybody. My dear, live your life. Just live your life as if the person is not existing. Don't go about spreading rumors, as in trying to put the person down, bringing up unnecessary, making up unnecessary stories about the person. Live your life as if the person is not existing. It's not in existence. Move on with your life. You know, ignore the person. Ignore everything about the person. Stop going around them, monitoring the person's life and trying to find everything about the person. You don't like this person. So why doing that? Because the more you do that, the more you try to bring up, as in, stir up more, will I say, hate and bitterness that is in you. So the best thing, the only good thing, you don't like someone, is enough. The only thing you will do is move on with your life. Live as if the person doesn't exist. That's the best thing. You get? And quit all this hatred, spreading false rumor, all this as in backbiting. Because if you are doing that, my dear, you are a witch. There's no difference between you and a witch, because as long as I'm concerned, a witch is someone that doesn't like good thing. They don't like seeing good thing. They don't like seeing good in people. So my dear, if you don't like someone, move on. Stop monitoring the person's life. Stop going about bringing up stories about the person, making up lies about the person. It's better for you to live your life like that person doesn't exist. That is the only way for you to deal with not being jealous and not turning to a witch. Yes, turning to a witch. So guys, and the only way for us all to be able to stand firm, you know, stand against every act of jealousy, envy in our life is by keeping our hands clean. Keep your hands clean. Make sure you as a person is not also practicing any act of jealousy or envy or hatred on someone, and make sure you live your life in a way that you are not living your life and making someone else sad, you know, deriving joy from someone's pain. Make sure you live your life in a way that you are not hurting anybody on purpose. Because why I said on purpose is sometimes you might live your life being happy. You don't know that as you are living your life and you are happy with the life you are living, someone out there is being hurt. So that's why I said on purpose. I'm not saying the one you, maybe what you did without you knowing that you are hurting this person. So that is it. So when you live your life, you know, in a way that you are not hurting someone, you are not envious about someone, you are not, when someone is jealous of you or trying to pull you down, my dear, it will not get to you. The person will not succeed because your hands are clean and you are not guilty of whatever the person is trying to bring up or whatever picture the person is trying to paint or pull up. So that is it. Another aspect you can use to deal with jealousy is prayers. Always pray to God to always protect you from people that are jealous of you, because sometimes people will be jealous of you and you are not even aware. They will be doing all manner of things. Even your so-called friends, most times they can be your friends. They are there. You don't know that secretly they are jealous of you. You don't know secretly they are trying to pull you down. They are doing all manner of things to pull you down without you knowing. Family members, yeah, they can also be jealous of you without you knowing. You know, they will come in front of you and pretend all good and all that, all this wonderful relationship, while behind your back, they are pulling you down. They are saying all manner of things about you. They are trying to block good things that are coming your way, you know, that kind of thing. So the way you can deal with all those things are by prayers. So you have to step up your game, you know. In this 2020, we have to step up our games, you know, in our prayer lives.
When you cannot afford the kind of life someone is living, or you don't have the kind of life someone is living at the moment, all you need to do is to pray that one day you will be able to have that person's kind of life and be able to have all those things that you don't have. And quit being jealous or bitter about the person or trying to bring the person down. That's not good at all. That's not good. In this 2020, you need a change. Guy, you need a change. Yes, guys, you need a change. Try to do better. Because good things come to people that are good, and bad things comes to people that are bad. So if you are doing good, good will surely come to you. If you are doing bad, bad will surely come to you. And whatever you wish for someone will definitely come to you. If you wish good for someone, it will come to you. If you wish bad for someone, it will come to you. You know, life has its own way of getting back on people. That is why karma is a bitch. Karma will always come for you. So it's better for you to live your life in a way that at the end of the day your hands are clean, you know. So your transparent life will speak for you, you know. Even when every other thing is speaking against you, even your own conscience will speak for you. Even when every other thing, every other person speaking against you, and everything around you is speaking against you, but your conscience, your clean hands, and God will always defend you, you know, and God will always stand up for you. So that is it. That is why in Igbo land they say Ofonog, Ejimo, Ofonog. I don't even know how to explain. My Igbo brothers and sisters, if you know how to explain what I just said, please let me know in the comment section. Ejimo, Ofonog, Ejimo, you know. So my brothers and sisters, that is all for this video. I have made my points. Just live your life in a way that you are not hurting anyone. You are not living your life in a way that someone else is in pain. As in trying to live in someone's pain. So how do I even shine in someone's pain? Use someone's pain to shine. But let me just put it up. You get, someone is in pain and you are happy about it, as in, no. If you're doing that, it's bad. It's bad, because one day that pain will get back to you. It will surely come back to you, and you know what it feels like to just live your life deriving joy from someone's pain, deriving happiness from someone's pain, or trying to push someone down, trying to paint someone bad, trying to make somebody feel bad. So this is all for this video, guys. Bye for now, and see you all in my next video. I know Jesus the Lord has won the victory.